The universe is jam-packed with weird, mind-bending celestial bodies that often test the outer limits of our understanding of theoretical physics. Throughout history, every now and then, a few cosmic flies in the ointment have turned up, leaving physicists scratching their heads saying, yeah, this is how it should work, but yeah, it's anyone's guess, really. One of those particular cosmic weirdos in question is the infamous neutron star, the strange wilderness era for any lucky solar sun in their celestial life cycle of the universe, where after being really big, they suddenly get really small and really dense, and physics just has to leave them be and let them do their thing. But what if our sun suddenly and out of nowhere became a neutron star? Well, let's find out. Hello internet, what's going on, and once again welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if our sun was a neutron star? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was from Danny Boyle's sci-fi extravaganza, Sunshine. And yeah, come on guys, this video is about our sun, so we've at least got to build some visual tension and atmospherically set the scene, right? Right, it leads us to an important point though, because there are no visual depictions of a neutron star because, well, they're so weird and so small that all the technology on the planet still couldn't manage to muster a few snapshots of the strange and mysterious solar bodies. But that's okay, because we've got everyone's favorite visual supplement to set the scene, theoretical physics. Right then, so neutron stars, what are they and what's the big deal? Well, in short, neutron stars are the collapsed cores of massive suns, but they have a few very particular parameters that they need to meet before they can call themselves neutron. Our sun, Sol, is pretty middle of the pack when it comes to the weirdness of far-flung celestial bodies, but stars with a much larger mass than our sun burn out after just a few million years in a massive galaxy-rocking explosion known as a supernova. During a supernova, all of the inner cosmic mush of the star in question, millions of tons of plasma and neutrinos, get ejected out from its core at the speed of light. But strangely enough, sometimes there's something left behind, and that little guy is a neutron star. Now, it's important to note that our sun will never become a neutron star because it doesn't meet those very specific set of parameters and conditions needed for it to turn into one. Neutron stars are born from suns that are 10 to 20 times the size of Sol, and in around 5 billion years, the life cycle of our sun will lead it to become a red giant and then eventually a cold white dwarf, which is vaguely similar to a neutron star without the weirdness, just much larger and far less dense. But we don't want that, do we? Because this is a hypothetical life's biggest question, and we want to know what this would mean for our sun and how damn dangerous things would get very, very quickly. What? You didn't expect a happy ending, did you? Well, it's no kept secret that a neutron star is one of the strangest things in our universe. It's right up there with dark energy and white holes, giant flying spaghetti monsters, Cthulhu and all his buddies. Because after spending its life as an absolutely massive star, post-supernova it shrinks down to roughly the size of a small city, around 20 kilometers from head to toe. But you know that stars are spherical, don't you? So don't worry about metaphorical appendages. The thing is though, the fact that these things are absolutely tiny on the scale of the universe, it doesn't account for the fact that a single cubic centimeter of a neutron star weighs roughly 400 million tons. A single cubic centimeter. Now multiply those centimeters by several hundred million and you get, yes, a pretty hefty small boy. In fact, even at that size, thanks to the weirdness of a neutron star's physics, its gravitational force would be roughly 2 billion times stronger than Earth's. That means quicker than a rat up a drain pipe, every single planet in our solar system would be instantly pulled toward the neutron star and destroyed in a hail of cosmic hellfire. Yeah, that's not so good. Also, things wouldn't just end there either, because these little guys rotate at a phenomenal speed outside of our given understanding of galactic orbit. You see, whereas our sun rotates once every 27 days or so, a neutron star would rotate roughly 700 times every second, and it would be hurtling through space at 1/5 the speed of light like a toddler at a Red Bull convention. In fact, if our sun was a neutron star, we'd likely never even know it, as life and everything in the galaxy would swiftly come to an end in the spark of an instant. That's if our sun suddenly morphed into a neutron star, but what if one of those guys came hurtling at us from the deep depths of space without a second thought. Even though a neutron star is roughly only 20 kilometers wide, when compared to our planet, which has a diameter of 13,000 kilometers, you may think that it'd be just like getting hit by an asteroid, but we're also forgetting how heavy these things are. Remember when I said a single cubic centimeter of a neutron star weighed roughly 400 million tons? Well, yeah. If it impacted our Earth, it would be like shooting a bullet through a watermelon. In fact, it's one of the few cosmic entities in the known universe that would literally obliterate our Earth by passing through the core of our planet and exiting out of the other side, 360 no scope and all. Yeah, it's safe to say these guys are pretty deadly, and under any theoretical scenario, things would be really, really bad if our sun ever became a neutron star. But is there any upside to our sun ever being a neutron star? Hypothetically, of course. Well, perhaps, but we'd have to change the mechanics of our solar system for that to even be an option. You see, because despite all of the cosmic calamity that these little guys can cause, it is still often theorized that neutron stars across the universe may have planets in orbit, albeit in a very precarious balance, stuck between a rock and a hard place, so to speak. You see, because neutron stars have such an overwhelming magnetic force, life on such a planet could harness that power, similar to how we harness visible light from Sol. Of course, for the most part, a neutron star would emit enough light energy, but the overwhelming radiation from its magnetic force could have completely shaped its course and evolution of any sentient life. An entirely new concept of life could have grown on this hypothetical planet that hangs in the delicate balance of a neutron star's orbit. Sentient life that fed on radiated cosmic energy to become an entirely different life form than that of humanity, using galactic cosmic rays to sustain themselves and perhaps become an even more efficient extraterrestrial life. Heck, if this radiated alien species became an advanced enough civilization, they could even perhaps construct a Dyson sphere, a hypothetical megastructure that completely encompasses the star and efficiently harnesses its energy. There's one thing for certain: whichever way you spin it, a neutron star has more potential energy than any known cosmic entity in our galaxy. If a civilization was lucky enough to grow in the strange, delicate balance of having a neutron star as a sun and survive its cosmic calamity and all the things that come with having one of the most earth-shattering entities in the known universe as a neighbor, then there's also a very good chance that their civilization would be incredibly advanced, thanks to the potential technological abundance of a neutron star. Hey, if that's the case, maybe they'll be paying us a visit sometime soon. Oh, I hope they're nice. Well, there we have it, folks, our short and long answer to the question, what if our sun was a neutron star? What did you guys think? Let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any choice remarks that you have on the matter. Before we depart from today's video, though, let's first take a quick look at some of your more resounding remarks from over the past few days. First up, Noctave says, Jack, if you see this, can I just say that I love this channel and I want to go to space one day? Aw, well, cheers, Noctave. That means a lot to us over here at LBQ. And also, you can go to space one day. Just brush up on your maths, get really good at spinning around in multitudes of G-force, get over any fear of heights you may have, and then the stars await. I believe in you. Go get them. Well, on that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video or just life's biggest questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button as well as that subscribe button, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching life's biggest questions, and until next time, you take it easy.